Friends, good morning. Today we'll concentrate on our next tutorials, that is on implicit intent. So we'll go deeply in one by one what are implicit intents. First, I want to create a one project. In a first project, I want to open camera. I want to open camera using implicit intent. So just I'm creating the project on the name of camera. So whenever user click on this, it automatically opens this camera. So once that open camera, remaining functionality should be controlled by the camera. As a developer, we could not do anything, just we open this camera. Then image capturing and all, it can be taken care by camera itself. So that is nothing but implicit intent. Means whatever this we are calling other third party application which already available on our phone, that can be controlled by the phone itself. We no need to know anything else. So that how it's happened, we can see here clearly. See here, just created a project camera. So still this project is loading. Once it is loaded, just I'll take one button. While clicking the button, just I'll open this camera. So how this will happen, we can see this. Just it's using a simply intent what we are using now, this explicit intent code. Almost it's a similar code, but there are small changes. How those small changes, as here we can able to check this. See here, just still it's a project is loading. Just dial up on Visor as well, so we can run our application in Visor. So here we'll apply listener based on the data binding only, because nowadays everyone are using data binding only. So data binding. So here just I'm changing as name as camera, means just I copy pasted this because it's already available somewhere. So just I copy paste this. So now here I want to call camera. So for this, just simply here I am applying here data binding. So that is data binding dot enabled equal to true. So just I apply data binding dot enabled equal to true. Then just I click on sync now. So to generate a data binding. Once this data binding has generated, now from here just I can add this binding. So then I'll apply the listener on the button. So I'm applying here, declaring here activity main binding, something binding. Then here binding equal to data binding util dot set content view. Now here it is context, just I applied here as a context. So then now as usually I'm applying this binding dot camera dot set on click listener, new view dot on click listener. So now here I'm applying this intent code, intent something declaration equal to new intent. And the second line could be here same as this start activity of intent. Here in our last video we write here this is the context comma target class, but here's one small change. Android dot provider dot media store. So Android dot provider dot media store dot action image capture. So because I want to capture the image, so image capture. This line I want to write once again this, because there is a small change in a latest architecture and a older architecture. Android dot provider dot. So like this. So just I'm commenting in a second line. Second line is the older architecture. That days it could not access directly the media store path, but nowadays it is accessing the as the this. So because of that, you're writing like this. But both are same. Either you can write this, you can write this. Both can be work out this. So that is. Once from here I open this. For this, no need to give any permissions in the manifest file. So no permissions, nothing. Just it can open camera automatically in our this. So that can be easily we can accessible here this. So that is a main advantage of this. Means with this line, your program has completed. But whenever you want to store this image and all, that is the next case. That we can able to see here. But now this is only this. This we cannot able to see this. See, once it is I'm running this application. Once it is run, we can able to check this output. So this is about this implicit intent camera. But there are few more advantages with these intents, implicit intents. What are those means? If it is an implicit intents, always the code is fixed. It's never change. Always code is fixed because it's always we are calling camera only. See here. Like this. It can be. See, once I click on this, camera is captured. Like this. See, once I click on this, again this camera is captured. See, like this. Even though once I open this camera, you can control, you can open this front camera as well. So like this, it can be, all should be, functionality should be controlled by camera. This is about this implicit intent, using implicit intent camera functionality. This is, please subscribe to get more updates. We'll see in the next videos the next things on the implicit intent.